right here today. You think we're stealing, right? You caught us. Shakespeare stole the plot from Plautus. Playwright steal, that isn't news. Enjoy these boys from Syracuse. Come on, all you ticket bearers. It's time to confront some comic terrors.
Antipholus, his servant Dromio. The twins are called the same name, befitting of their station.
Or maybe Syracusans lack enough imagination.
My wife was called Emilia. She had the worth of 10. What fortune I would give right now to see them all again.
Oh, sad! Oh, sad!
Day that is.
story and has changed the penalty. I have one day to play him off. That's the end of me. Does anyone have any cash to lend me for a day? No, I didn't think so. I'd better go my way.
We haven't seen since we were children. We've been in every town and village in the entire Middle East looking for them. No luck.
Well, it's death to every Syracusan who comes to Ephesus. Get out of town fast or you'll lose your fortune, if not your life.
Take this one.
about taking our stuff that we brought from Epidamnum over to the Centaur? All the guys from Epidamnum stay there when they're in Ephesus. Okay. Oh, and don't forget the money. Stash it in a safe place. We are going to need funds when we get back to Epidamnum. I'll walk around and check this couch. Yeah.
Hey, Antipholus, how's it going?
Do what?
Antipholus, my name, hey, maestro. Come here. Hey. Remember that wine I told you about? It just came in from Palermo. It's fantastic. It takes a pomegranate and a tiny hint of the olive wood cask. They make it in. Look at this bottle. Take a look. Phoenician glass. Hey, remember the wine we had at Mycenae's dinner party? Pretty powerful stuff. Had an amazing effect on you, my friend.
Excuse me. Do I know you? I just arrived from Epidamnum.
Oh, right. Okay, yeah. Giving Adriana the slip again, huh? Yeah, no, I don't know you. No, I don't know you from Adam.
I don't know what.
No way. Antipholus, you just got
it. What?
Come on over. We're serving goats the way you like it, with the black olives and the turmeric spice.
What? Well,
yeah. Magnificent.
How does she know? I do like goat with olives, so. Master! There you are! Come home! The mistress is in a state! The food's been ready for over an hour. Capon is burnt, everything is dried out. I've been looking all over for you.
What home? We're from Epidamnum. That's where we've just arrived from. And what's a capon?
And this is a joke, right? You're gonna say, how many sailors from Epidamnum does it take to change and all that? Come on, master, give it a rest. Come home, your wife will be furious.
Oh, Dromio, have you been drinking? I have no wife.
Where is the money I gave you to deposit? What have you done with it?
What money? What are you talking about?
Oh, the 20 ducats you gave me last week to buy an Ephesus army knot because I was a good boy.
The money! The big bag of money we brought from home. In the suitcase. You took to the inn?
This money you do not know about.
You idiot! Don't fool with me! This is not funny! Have you spent it?
I don't remember. This conversation is going nowhere. I don't suppose you want to call Flame Protective Services.
I try to keep myself in good condition. It's over at the Centaur with all our stuff.
It's nice that you tell me this now. You just told me I hadn't given you any money. You said I should go home and have dinner with my wife.
Hold it, boss. You're playing some kind of game with me. I'd laugh if you weren't carrying such heavy fruit. Maybe we can talk this out. Haven't you ever heard of conflict resolution? Now think you said you told me to take our stuff to the Centaur!
Antipholus! Where have you been? Why have you been ignoring me? Come home now and let's have supper! Husband!
What?
You used to say my looks were pleasing in your eye, my words music in your ear, and now you spurn me and look away and frown and left alone and wonder why? Antipholus!
Please answer me, fair dame. I know you not. We just got here from
send up like red flags for a sport though.
gross and completely disgusting if they allowed you to belch obscenely after each meal. Remember, in the fates we've got to be trusting. We've got to play it cool, it's part of the deal. If they scoop their mashed potatoes and they throw them, if they slurp their soup bag in their peas with a knife, got to say, they're not so bad when you know them. A positive attitude could save your life.
Fit in, you got to fit in. And do whatever that gentleman do, whatever that is. And pretty soon it's crazy that I will be through. Just remember, we got to fit in.
If they drink from a finger bowl, totally lose control.
If they say they hate rock and roll. We've got to fit in.
Everyone is welcome. Occasionally, my wife is a little bit upset when I'm late. Bear with her if she rails a bit. No. I'm very pleased that you could partake in our hospitality, and I'm sure my wife will be too.
As long as you don't feel we're imposing.
Not at all. No. Now, wait a minute. This is a bit of a problem. The door seems to be bolted. Adriana, we have guests. Let me in. Dromio, knock on the door.
Okay.
All within there, the master has returned. Open up.
The master and his ever resourceful servant are within. Go away.
The master is out here, with guests, waiting to be let in.
I have strict instructions from the mistress not to open the door to anyone.
I'll handle this. Is Adriana inside? Let me talk to her.
The mistress is not to be disturbed. She has guests.
This is some stunt. Adriana's going to teach me a lesson. Well, she's not going to keep me out. Not out of my house. Dromio, go get me a rope. A rope! A man is master of his liberty. His wife is mistress of his fate. She makes him exercise his liberty when she locks him out of the house and bars the gate. But for those of us with plenty of resources, always is another place to dine. Gentlemen, let's marshal up our forces and remove our party to the Porpentine. There's a lady there I always like to see, of aspect sweet and discourse witty. Whenever I'm stuck with plan B, have to spend the evening in the city. Can't blame me if I don't stay. Adriana's everything wonderful that they say, but she's always frantic. It isn't romantic, and her latest antic just drives me away. Can't blame me if I depart. Stop this fight before she can start. It really gets to me. Someday she may sue me. But if she just knew me, I'm really all heart.
Promised, Adriana.
Of course.
Bring it to me in the Porpentine. I may give it to the
lady who resides there. That'll show my wife. She thinks she can keep me out and entertain guests. Well, she's going to get a surprise.
This isn't going well at all. I think being in company makes me feel even more alone. What am I doing here? Looking for my brother? It's crazy. It's like being a drop of water in the ocean looking for another drop.
I have crossed the seas looking for my twin. It's a lonely life, not like any other. And I wonder what kind of life I'm in. Never finding, always searching for a brother. And I never stop to say hello. Never wanted to, as far as I can tell. Though there may have been a girl or two, I know. I guess I have loved wisely, but not well. When I hear each well-known soliloquy, by the playwright they always call the bard, I imagine they all apply to me. Like Romeo, I am fortune's fool. Why don't the stars show me a better fate? If music be the food of love, I'll play. And maybe end my solitary state. They say all the world's a stage. I've been to all the world, and well, I know it. It seems I play the fool at every age, and the lunatic, the lover, and the poet. Tomorrow and tomorrow hold for me an empty stage with many Louises. Hamlet said, or not to be, and now I know exactly what he means.
And the crazy thing is, everyone here thinks they know me. That woman, Adriana, she's too much! What? Other one? Her sister? She's just...
Antipholus, have you forgot a husband's duty? In the very springs of love, thy love springs rot. Or maybe you've gone off to see some cutie.
Peace, fair mistress, I understand you not.
Let you be clear. If you want my sister for her wealth, then for her wealth use her with more kindness. Or if you like elsewhere, do so by stealth. Muffle your false love with a show of blindness. Alas, poor woman, make her but believe.
Give my sleeve, my arm, and my heart too, if you just listen to my plea. Tell me, what do I have to do to get you to consider me?
myself, my own self's better part. My eyes clear high, my own heart's dearer heart. Thee will I love, and with thee lead my life. You have no husband yet.
I have no wife.
What's going on here? Witchcraft, sorcery.
Why, what happened? Did this wife of yours feed you?
Sure, the food was great. An enormous fiesta. I can't complain. A delightful repast. But then she says, what about a siesta? Well, you know how we handle that. Get out of there fast! Fit in! We don't want to. We don't think we belong in this neighborhood. We had better get out while the getting is good. No way we're staying here. We don't want to fit in. The same with me. They believe I am married to a kitchen wench, all covered in grease. So you see, I'm a little bit hairy. If this is jail, I want early release. Fit in. We don't want to fit in. We don't think we belong in this neighborhood. We had better get out while the getting is good. No way we're staying here. We don't want to fit in.
Yeah, we've seen the lay of the land.
Things have gotten a bit out of hand.
Hey, let's blow this popsicle stand.
Like Ozzy and Harriet. My view of relationships. dating guys is really much the same. They're all into wine'em and dine'em. I'm tired of playing that game. To paraphrase Gloria Steinem, a woman needs a husband like a fish, needs a bicycle like a sparrow, needs a hairdo or a cow needs a phone. They think they shine.
chain to my wife, and she will pay.
Antipholus, my friend, I did not doubt you. I'll bring the chain to her if you think best. A moment, do you have the chain about you? I need the payment to avoid arrest.
I'm sorry, ma'am, I don't quite understand you. Your problem in this circumstance, I see. The chain I find impossible to hand you, because you haven't given it to me.
Small cheer and great welcome make a merry feast. This cup that has security, the markets will police. And if beneath the stealing or a bet that hurts a riot, well, none of us do know that you would ever think to try it.
Oh, I did so well, knowing very well, sir.
Soldier and great, welcome, make a merry feast. If the tinker fell first, soon the rebels will have sheets. We always have a spread like this, it happens every year. Let's you get pulled it off again. Here, here, here!
Antipholus, you're under arrest.
Oh.
Move!
Oh.
Well, master, I brought the...
promise me.
Oh! Avaunt, Satan! I charge you, tempt me not.
It's a little too late for that.
Ah, master! Is this mistress Satan?
No, she's worse. She's the devil's dam dressed in the costume of a light witch.
You and your man are merry, sir. Now, why don't you come home with me, and we can talk about
it. No! Avaunt!
Well, at least give me the ring I gave you at dinner.
You see what's happening? I don't. She wants my ring for a spell. You know these witches. Sometimes they want a few hair strands, sometimes nail pairings, or a bit of cloth from your shirt.
Cloth.
This one is greedy.
Greedy.
She wants a ring.
Ring.
Let's get out of here! Let's get out of here!
Ten.
Then I'd better tell his wife. He's got my ring. It cost 40 ducats. But why should she care? I'll tell her he rushed into my house and took away my ring by force. That's the course I fittest choose. 'Cause 40 ducats is too much to lose. Ladies!
I'm a man of important position. my prisoner, and I will not let you have him.
We need to take him home.
The money he owes will be required of me.
I will discharge the money. Bring me to his creditor, and I'll pay him off.
Very well.
Doctor, please see my husband safely home.
You don't care about me.
Who had him arrested?
The goldsmith, Angela. Do you know her?
How much does he owe?
400 ducats, due for a chain that he got from her.
He ordered the chain, but he never received it.
But your husband came to my house, all in a rage, and took away my ring. That ring I just saw on his finger. Right after that, I saw him with the chain.
I never saw it! Officer, take me to the goldsmith. I want to find out the truth.
Witches are afraid of swords.
She that would be your wife ran away from you.
It's all very bizarre. I don't know, Dromio. There might be a trap. Perhaps it would help if we briefly
recap.
So right here in Ephesus, the land of the ship, but it turned out I had just begun my trip. When I showed up, they knew me like I was king. A goldfish comes up and gives me some play, and all of a sudden comes up this wife. I felt like I was living in some double life.
So I tell the first girl, I know what he's
missing. Besides, you know, I want to date your sister.
Here come the men in black.
So I'm telling you, this is incredibly strange. Your entire life story is subject to change. Be wary out there. Things are not what they seem.
I think we are living in somebody's dream.
So the boss tells me take our stuff to the inn. And this is where all my trouble begins. Cause when I get back, the boss is gonna choose.
What? You got wrong!
I'm facing abuse from these ladies and cops. And give us free food. And we're like,
what?
We don't wanna be rude when this woman comes up. Resembling a swine with bread like hot peppers. And says that she's mine.
So I'm telling you, this is incredibly strange. Your entire life story is subject to change. Be wary out there, things are not what they seem. I think we are living in somebody's dream.
So I go to my house, my wife wants me out, and she tells me this stuff that I can't help but doubt. Like a goldsmith who tells me that he's got a bill for some gold I ain't got, man, I wish he'd just chill. So I go to a friend's house to get me some bread. Well, I can't go back home, because my wife's down the chest. Then the goldsmith has stopped me, and wouldn't you know, before I can stop him, I'm cut my
fire.
Here come the men in black.
So I'm telling you, this is incredibly strange. Your entire life story is subject to change. Be wary out there, things are not what they seem. I think we are living in somebody's dream.
Come home is what I say when I see my boss. He replies, we don't live here.
Are you back up the stars?
Then he sends me away, or like a rope. When I bring it, he slaps me and calls me a dope. Now he wants the boat. I'm dreaming I was exotic. Suddenly it hits me, this guy's psychotic. So I'm telling you, this is incredibly strange. Your entire life story is subject to change. Be wary out there, these are not what they seem. I think we are living in somebody's dream.
This place is bewitched, this is some kind of plot.
We're gonna crack up, more likely than not. My master has finally gone round the bend. I wish this insanity would finally end.
So now, on to the centaur. Let's get the rest of our stuff and get out of here.
I don't know, boss. What would one more night hurt? They've been so kind, giving us gold. They're such a gentle nation. If it weren't for that kitchen wench who claims me for a husband, I'd be glad to stay here and turn witch.
I wouldn't stay tonight for the whole town. Therefore, away!
The night is long, but never finds the day.
Now, what you've just seen is swamp gases glowing off the planet Venus.
to delay in giving you your money, but Antipholus did have the chain of me, even though he denies it.
How is he esteemed in the city?
Antipholus is well known and generally respected. His word can usually be counted on, but he's got the chain about his neck, the liar!
Good sir!
I wonder that you would bring me to such trouble and scandal and bring so much shame upon yourself, going to such extremes as to deny you ever received the chain when I see you are wearing it now?
I never denied that I had the chain.
Yes, you did deny and forswore it too.
Who heard me deny or forswear that I had the chain?
These ears of mine heard it.
And mine too. It's a wonder that you can stand there and lie so boldly. You shouldn't be allowed out with decent people.
You're a villain to accuse me thus. I'll prove my honor and my honesty, too. Dromio? Dromio!
What? What?
Knife! Come on. All right, one more time.
Get it together.
I'll prove my honor and my honesty, too.
Oh, that's what you meant with the clapping. The knife.
Okay,
so, right, hold
just
on.
Give me the knife.
Look, it's in the bag. You said we were leaving.
Okay, could you...
I can't work on these conditions.
Okay, again, one more time.
I'll prove my honor and my honesty to you.
I'll defy thee for a villain.
Why did you fight?
My reason was the honor.
so I give him some pain to feel. And Dromio and I managed to escape. And now, finally, sire, I want ample satisfaction for these deep griefs and great indignities.
My lord, thus far do I witness with him. He was locked out and did not dine at home.
But did he have the chain?
He did, my lord. When he ran in there, all these people saw he had it.
I heard you tell him right here you did have the chain of him.
Oh, when did I?
Right before you ran into this abbey here.
I've never been in that abbey in my life.
I think you all have been drinking from Circe's cup. If he had run into the abbey, he would still be there. If he were mad, his story wouldn't make so much sense. All these merchants swear they were locked out of half.
Sir, he was locked out and dined with her at the Porpentine.
He did. And from my finger snatched that ring.
Duke, it's true. She gave me that ring.
Snatched!
Someone who might save my life and pay the sum that can deliver me. Is not your name, sir, called Antipholus? And this is your bondsman called Dromio?
I was a bondsman, but now I am unbound.
I'm sure you both remember me.
We remember ourselves by you. Because recently we were tied up like you are.
I have never seen you in my life till now.
Grief changed me so much. But do you know my voice?
No.
Nor I.
Time has so changed my voice that my own son doesn't even recognize me. Tell me, are you my son Antipholus?
I've never been to Syracuse, and the Duke and all these people shall say that it is so.
It was just 7 years since in Syracuse that we parted. Oh, perhaps you're ashamed to acknowledge me in my grief.
I tell thee, Syracusan, 20 years I have been patron to Antipholus, during which time he never saw Syracusa. I think your age and dangers have confused you.
Most mighty Duke, behold, a man must be. Whoa!
Oh,
I see two husbands in my eyes.
One man is genius to the other. Which is the natural man and which is the spirit?
I, sir, am Dromio. Command him away.
I, sir, am Dromio. Let me stay.
I think it's panic time.
Is it a bliss bewitched? Him? Dromio? Is this the work of the devil? They're translated.
This story happened quite a long time ago. We're looking ahead in time to the Dark Ages. When a natural phenomenon happens, what do we know?
In science, we don't have much sophistication. We can't explain an eclipse or shooting star. So we come up with the obvious explanation.
Some are born with brown eyes, some with blue. Why, some are very smart, and some athletic. But we'll have to wait 1,000 years or two.
Everyone is born alone, but not this one, he's a clone.
How much more proof of evil can there be?
They're exact to every hair and follicle. I think the proof is there, it's diabolical.
Someday, we will know traits are inherited, but we don't know that kind of stuff today. Your future's what you've got, not what you've merited. It's not in your stars, it's in your DNA.
But until the truth emerges from the mist, we all believe we need an exorcist.
Someday, we will all have facts empirical to say why some are lefty, some are right. But for now, it's just a miracle that these two men are equal in our sight.
Inspiration, you're the one I've
waited for. You're the queen of my imagination. And I
stop. You shouldn't say anymore.
It is thyself, my own self's better part.
My eyes clear eye, my heart's clearer car.
Thee will I love, and with thee lead my life.
You have no husband
yet.
I have a wife.
Sire, I offer the ransom for my father and plead sanctuary for my brother and his servant.
One second.
What is it?
Five before sundown. There is no need. The Syracusans are free.
Yes! Oh my God. I guess we won't be going back to Syracuse.
We all want to be together.
Oh, you're gonna stay in Syracuse right now.
It looks like they're about to be Ephesian.
So the cooking isn't what you call Parisian.
Who cares about that? This is where it is at. Start celebrating!